Welcome back, coders. Let's look at the magical powers of the let keyword in JavaScript. It's not just a better way to declare variables, it's a game changer. Let's break it down. Back in the day, JavaScript didn't have block scope. Variables declared with var spilled everywhere, either into the global scope or function scope. But in ES6, let introduced block scope, which confines variables inside blocks, like little fenced gardens for your code. In this example, let x equals 2 is declared inside a block. If you try to use x outside the block, JavaScript throws an error. It's protected nice and secure. Okay, but why should you care about block scope? Let's compare let and var. Variables declared with var can sneak outside the block they're declared in. When you use var, the variable x doesn't respect the block. It escapes and becomes available globally, which can be messy and prone to cause bugs. But let, it keeps things local to the block. Here's another problem with var, redeclaration. With var, you can declare the same variable multiple times, even in the same scope, which can accidentally overwrite your data. Using var, you might accidentally redeclare x and overwrite its original value. Not great for debugging. With let, JavaScript protects you. You can't redeclare x in the same block. It throws an error to keep your code safe. But don't worry, let isn't overly strict. You can of course declare a variable in a different block. With block scope, this is not redeclaration. It's a new variable that lives in the specific scope. Each block gets its own x. The value in one block doesn't affect the others. It's all nice and isolated. Now let's talk about hoisting. Variables declared with var are hoisted, meaning they're moved to the top of their scope and initialized as undefined. This can lead to unintended consequences, or sometimes bugs. But let works differently. It's also hoisted to the top of the block, but it's not initialized. So if you try to use a let variable before declaring it, you'll get an error. To wrap it up, here's the difference. Let gives you block scope, prevents redeclaration, and avoids hoisting-related bugs. It's safer, cleaner, and more reliable than var. So there you have it, coders. Use let to write cleaner, more maintainable JavaScript. Say goodbye to messy var problems and hello to safer, smarter code. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe to get notified about our latest videos. For more coding tips and tricks, keep it locked right here on w3schools.com. Don't forget to try out what you've learned in our interactive editor. Happy coding!